The following program is sponsored by Friends and Partners of Kingdom Connection.
Hello and welcome to a very special edition of Kingdom Connection. I am so glad you joined me today, and I have a faith-building, inspiring, uplifting message that I believe is going to strengthen your faith and encourage you today. I believe this program is exactly what, you know, you need to hear. Sometimes you need a faith boost. Sometimes you need to hear the Word of God in the areas and the challenges that you're facing. What does God's Word say about my situation? And that's what I'm going to talk about today. And normally, you know, we come from the auditorium here at Free Chapel, but I just wanted it to be kind of one-on-one. I want you to get a cup of coffee or whatever you have there, wherever you're watching this program, and sit down. Give me the next 15 or 20 minutes of your life. I've got something to say to you that I believe is more than a sermon. I believe it's a prophetic message that I'm going to decree over your life, over your family, over your needs. You know, God is so concerned about you, and He knows how to get the blessing to the location where you are. And you may feel like you're in a desert. You may feel like you're a million miles away from what you need. You may feel like, you know, I'm isolated. There's no way that I will ever see God bless me in the place that I am. And that's what I want to talk to you about. I heard a minister give reference to this story that I'm going to share with you. And it's so intrigued me that I checked it out and even saw the TV show myself about the fact that the Weather Channel and Discovery Channel, National Geographic, they all researched what I'm talking about, what I'm going to share with you, and they verified this actually happened. Now, I want you to listen. I want you to listen carefully. This is a true story that happened recently in a northern territory of Australia. That is in the outback. It's a desert area. It's 500 miles from any body of water. And yet they had a phenomenon happen. It began to rain, and that in itself is not so unusual. It usually rains one time in this desert region. But not only did it rain and water, it rained fish. Fish fell out of the sky. Perch fish, to be exact, fell out of the sky into a desert village, and some of the fish were frozen and some of the fish were alive. I'm not making this up. Again, the Weather Channel documented this, and National Geographic did a whole special show on this. And it was an amazing thing. And what they believe happened was there was a whirlwind or perhaps a small tornado that got over the ocean, which was 500 miles away. A water sprout, I guess you could call it, formed, sucked the fish up, took them up into the atmosphere. Some of them went so high that they froze. Others stayed in the perfect atmosphere. If you can imagine, the fish are flopping around up in the clouds, you know, because it was just enough moisture to keep them alive. Then a wind came and blew that wind funnel or water sprout out 500 miles into the outback desert. And when it hit that hot desert atmosphere, it began to condense and drop. Whatever was in the sky dropped. And suddenly these people, can you imagine these people in the village who live 500 miles away from anywhere where there's fish? And maybe somebody had just said that morning, man, I'd love to have a good fish dinner today. Wouldn't it be great to have some nice fresh fish, not the old frozen kind that we've had, you know, in the freezer for 3 months, but fresh fish right out of the ocean. And here it comes flopping and plopping out of the sky. Fish start raining in the desert. I'm telling you that I believe that even nature can become God's evangelist. God can speak sometimes through things like that to us. You may feel like you're in a desert. You may feel like you're so far from the source, and there's just no way God could bless you, and there's just no way that you could get a breakthrough. But I'm going to tell you, when God decides to bless you, He can make it rain fish. When God decides to bless you, you don't have to have a boat, a rod and reel. You don't have to have all of the things that people think are necessary. You can even be in the desert and go fishing when God decides to bless you, because the fish began to fall out of the sky and it was raining fish. Now, of course, fish in the Bible, and this is interesting because fish in the Bible are always a type of the harvest. They're always a type of that which, you know, God wants to bring into our life. He said, I'll make you. He told the disciples, follow me, and I'll make you fishers of men. Some of the disciples were professional fishermen when Jesus called them into the ministry. But he said, I want to make you a different kind of fisherman. So the fish speak to us of the harvest that God wants to send. And I believe specifically that there are three harvests that God wants to rain fish into your life in these three areas. He wants to send to your desert, to the place that you think that there's just no way that God could bless me here in this area of my life. There are three things the fish represent to you today. Number one, I believe the fish raining speaks of the ability of God to bring brand new people into our churches, into the kingdom, into our lives, into our destiny, into our calling. I want to speak prophetically now and say there's new people coming into your life, blessing people, people who are connected to your destiny, people who will help open doors, people who will help get you where you're supposed to go. You know, I look back over my life and I see that in every transition and every time that God was about to take me to another level, that He would introduce new people first into my life. And those people were connected to the next level of my destiny. And there are new people. Some of you are single watching me right now. And I'm just telling you, new people are coming into your life. Get your faith up. It's raining fish. Maybe you've been in a desert socially. Maybe you've been in a desert. Do you say, well, God doesn't care about that. Well, He cared about Ruth. Ruth was lonely. Ruth was a widow. Ruth had lost her husband and her family, and she was depressed and discouraged. But God knew her name. God knew where she was, and God put her in a certain field, and God brought Boaz into her life, and God blessed her in an amazing way. And God knows how to make it rain new people in your life. And the Bible said that one day Jesus told the disciples, take your nets and cast them into the deep. Cast them into the deep. And the Bible said Peter took one net. Jesus said take nets, plural, but he took one net. And you know why I think he took one net? Because he had already cleaned the nets. It takes a lot of work to clean the nets. It reminds me of a lot of churches. We had rather have clean nets than catch fish. If we're not careful, we brag about how clean our church is and how holy we are, and we're not catching any fish. And fish is the harvest, the souls, the lost. I'd rather have dirty nets with some fish in them than a bunch of clean nets where we brag how clean and how holy we are and we're not catching fish. And Peter took one net and went out and did what Jesus said, and the net began to break in blessing, and he had to call other ships in because his ship was sinking in blessing. And I want to say that, you know, we want God to fill up our church, but God's interested in filling up His kingdom. Now, that's why I love the fact that they partnered with the other boats. It might have been a Baptist boat, a Methodist boat, a Pentecostal boat, a Charismatic boat. We need to quit fighting one another. We need to get our guns off of each other and attacking one another and putting down one another and talking about what we don't agree with all the time, and gather under what we do agree in, Calvary, the blood of Jesus, the name of Jesus, and let's fill up our boats. Let's send out the nets. Let's send out the boats. And I'm speaking over ministries today that it's raining fish, and get ready for brand new people from the north, from the south, from the east, from the west. Come on, pastors. Come on, youth pastors. Come on, church people who are involved in volunteering and helping your local church. Let's agree together that this is an hour when God is ready to rain fish. Plop, 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 plop. They're just going to start falling into our ministries. People are just going to start showing up. And we need to be ready. And when they show up, don't worry about cleaning the fish. Let's just catch them. Let's catch the fish and let the Holy Spirit clean them. Let's preach the Word and let God clean them. I don't care if they got one ring, three rings, nine rings, 19 tattoos. Who cares? Let's just cast the net and catch the fish and let the Holy Spirit clean people up. That's His business. And what you think is normal, people may think you're weird. They may think you look funny. So let's let God do all of that and let's just love people. And let's believe for brand new people. So right where you are, I want you to say, brand new people are coming into my life. People who are connected to my destiny. People who I'm supposed to help. People whom I can use my influence to help reach. They're coming into my church, into my ministry. Some of you pastors need to get your faith up. Brand new people, brand new members are coming. And then secondly, I see something in this that not only is it going to be new people, but it's going to be the money that you need, the resources that you need. It's time for it to rain fish. And one time Jesus said in Scripture, he said, you know, we've got a tax bill, Simon Peter, and I want you to go down to the Sea of Galilee, and I want you to take a hook, and I want you to put it in the water, and the first fish that you catch, open his mouth. And there will be a coin, a gold coin in his mouth. Take the money out of the fish's mouth and pay the tax bill. Jesus had a bill. Now, can you relate to this? Jesus had a bill that he couldn't pay. Jesus had a need, a financial need that he did not have the resources for. And yet he said the key to it is to fish. The key to it is to reach the harvest. The key to all of our needs being supplied is to keep trying to reach the fish. And so he said, Peter, go down and go fishing. And if you fish, I'll supply your needs. If you'll build the kingdom, if you'll seek first the kingdom, if you'll put the church and the kingdom of God first, I'm going to bless you. And he pulled money out of that fish's mouth and went and paid the tax bill. I've come by today to say to somebody who's listening to me, we serve a God who is still our provider. I want to say that again. God is still your provider. The God who put gold in the fish's mouth that Simon Peter caught and paid his bill can help you pay your bills. He's concerned. You're stressed out. You're worried. You don't know what you're going to do. I'm going to tell you what you're going to do. You're going to do what you know to do. Trust God. Sow. Give. Obey God. Worship God. I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging for bread. And I want you to hear that he's Jehovah Jireh. He's El Shaddai, not El Cheapo. He knows how to bless you. He knows how to meet your needs. Some of you need a job. It's raining fish right in the middle of your desert. You've looked and looked and looked, but there's something called favor that can come on your life. There's something called in the book of Revelation, an open door that no man can shut. Oh, praise God. An open door that no man can shut. It's raining fish. And it's time to get your faith up. It's time to say, Lord, I thank you that you are my source. You know, we started a work many years ago in Haiti. And you know all about it. If you watch this program, we built 100 homes there and we've dug wells there and we've helped with a hospital there and we've provided 540,000 meals a month for many years now. That's just ongoing. It's a check every month for $20,000 a month that we've been sending year after year after year after year from Kingdom Connection, from this ministry. And you know, we just finished the warehouse, the food distribution center, 30,000 square feet. And I'm going in a few weeks to dedicate it. Keep watching. You'll see that live dedication that's going to take place of that beautiful facility, massive, as long as a football field building that is filled to the roof with food that you have supplied for the starving, and I'm not exaggerating, the starving, hungry children of Haiti. By the tens of thousands, we're feeding them every month. And you know, the Lord spoke to my heart again, and we're working with our missionaries, Bobby and Sherry, and the thought, you know, came, we can give fish to a person, the old saying, or you can teach them to fish. And so we have decided to partner with our missionaries in Haiti and build a miracle marketplace. And what we're going to do is we're going to provide thousands of jobs. They estimate that it'll be over 2,400 jobs that will be provided for Haitian people where there's over 85% unemployment. Listen to me, over 85% of the people do not have a job, cannot find a job. There are no jobs to be found. But we are going to provide over 2,400 jobs, over 600 businesses there of the Haitian-owned, Haitian-operated. It'll be like a huge ministry place that we have a radio station with a ministry that we're Bobby and Sherry and Love a Child, and it'll be Christian music playing all through it. They can bring their chickens, they can bring their eggs, they can bring their handiwork. The Haitian people are very creative. They make things with their hands, clothing. They can sell, they can buy, they can trade. It's going to be amazing. It's going to shake up the whole region, I think, touch the whole nation, become a prototype for the whole. Come on and dream with me. And, you know, and so we committed $1 million to this project over the next 12 months, starting this month. I don't have that money, but I just believe God's going to cause it to rain fish. I just believe if we go, because in that is, once that happens, it begins to resource the orphanage that we have there, resource the feeding programs that we have there, resource the mountain regions where it is such poverty that you cannot imagine. I've seen them. I've held the babies with the bloated stomachs, dying of starvation. I've held them myself in my hands, and I know this is real. But this will be a perpetual way of even raising more resources to pour into the starving and the hungry and the hurting and the broken. And so I get excited about it. But, you know, I made that $1 million commitment to that cause, and I thought, Lord, you know, that's a lot of money, and how are we going to do this? And I'm just telling you that no sooner had we made the commitment, there was a businessman who heard about it, and he wrote the first $100,000 check out of the $1 million that we needed. He wrote a $100,000 check, plop. It just fell right out of the sky. A man I had never met before, a man I had never been introduced to before. That's how God does it, and we're believing that He will continue to meet the needs. My point is this: you've got needs, you've got situations in your life, and the Lord wants me to remind you that man is not your source. God is your source. God is going to bless you. He'll bless you and make you the head and not the tail, above only and not beneath. This isn't prosperity gospel. This is the gospel. And part of the gospel is He is a provider. So He's going to bring the fish. It's raining fish means He's going to bring new people into your life. He's going to bring the money, the resources that you need into your life. And lastly, it has to do with miracles. You see, Jesus said when He needed 5,000 hungry people fed, what do you have? And they said, we have 5 pieces of bread and 2 fish. And He said, put them in my hands. This is the powerful part. Take what you've got and put them in the hands of Jesus. Give Him your talent. Give Him your future. Give Him your relationship. Give Him your problems. Put it in Jesus' hands. You know, a golf club in my hands isn't worth very much. But a golf club in the hands of Tiger Woods is worth a lot of money. And that's the difference between the hands. Well, you put what you've got in Jesus' hands and watch what He can do with what you've got. And so I believe it's raining miracles because the Bible said that Jesus multiplied the fish and multiplied the loaves. And you serve that same miracle worker today. The same God who fed Elijah with ravens and the birds flew in every day through the famine. The same God who took an old man named Abraham, 100 years old, and his wife, 99 years old, and caused them to give birth to a son, and he became a nation. The same God who caused a virgin named Mary, who had never known a man, to become pregnant and give birth to the Son of God, That same God is your God. Don't tell me He can't meet your need. Don't tell me He can't heal your body. Don't tell me He can't save your family. It's raining miracles. It's raining fish. And if He could multiply the fish and the loaves, He can give a miracle to you today, and I want to pray for you. Maybe you need the miracle of deliverance. Maybe you're bound by drug addiction, alcoholism, maybe one of your children. Maybe you're listening to me and you have cancer, or you have heart disease, you're facing the biggest financial mountain you've ever faced. I speak in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, and Lord, I thank You that there's power in that name, power to heal. But He was wounded for your transgressions, bruised for your iniquities, and by His stripes you're healed. Financial mountain, move in Jesus' name. We speak to You, and we thank You, Lord, that You're sending the resources. It's going to rain fish in somebody's desert today. I pray for miracles, miracles in homes, miracles in marriages, miracles in people's physical bodies. Lord, I pray that even ministries, that new people would come, new money, resources would come. Miracles, money, and new people are coming into your life. I'm in agreement with you. And if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Savior, pick up that phone and dial that number on the screen. Just say, Lord Jesus, be my Savior. Cleanse me. Set me free. Break these chains of addiction off of my life. I believe in You, Jesus Christ. If you'll call on that name, He'll save you. Are you in faith with me? I'm believing for you. New people, blessing people are coming into your life. Resources, money that you need to do the will of God. And lastly, miracles. Oh yes, He's a God of miracles. And we decree His name and His power and His miracles over your family, over your life, and over every need that you have. I'll be right back in just a moment.
I was excited, but I had no idea that it would be life-changing. I went in with one expectation and came out a completely different person.
The gathering of women together and being filled with the Holy Spirit can break the power of Satan that's coming to wipe out our marriages and our sons and our daughters and our grandchildren.
Would you be willing, as you become aware of God's presence with you, to be empowered to be the one that steps out and away from the crowd? Because listen, intimacy with Jesus depends on it.
Because I want you to remember, the same God that did that is able to deal with this. Whatever God did back then, God is able to do now.
You're doing something I can't even see. I can't even begin to understand how this could end in a victory. But you're in this, so you're going to be on this.
He chose me for a divine purpose, and I found that through this conference.
As my dad mentioned, we are embarking on the largest initiative in Kingdom Connection history in the nation of Haiti, the Miracle Market. For more information on this project, here are our missionaries, Bobby and Sherry Burnett, for an update.
Pastor Jensen, the marketplace is one of the most exciting projects we've ever partnered with, and thank you for partnering with Love a Child and making this possible. Mm-hmm. You're sponsoring it 100%. It's going to cost $1 million, but it's going to change lives forever.
Yes.
You know, Haiti is 85% unemployment. Mm-hmm. No, very few people have jobs. And this whole area.
And they want jobs.
And they want jobs. They want to work.
Yes.
And in this area, it's going to change it from poverty to prosperity. Not only for this area of Fonperazin, but all the yes. areas in between and even far off. People will be coming here, selling their goods, wholesalers, retailers. It'll be a sustainability project. And what's going to happen is helping Haitians help themselves.
Food for life.
And we'll believe in God. The Lord has put in our spirit for everyone who sells in the marketplace, mm-hmm. everyone who has a job in the marketplace, which will be hundreds of them. We're believing God that back for every job in the
yes.
marketplace, that back in America,
yes.
God would give a hundredfold return, that 100 people will have jobs in America. That's what we're believing the Lord for.
Absolutely. You know, Bobby, when they have jobs, they know, number one, that Voodoo did not give them this job. They will all know that God is the one who cares about the whole man. Their health, and their prosperity and their children and their lives. God is a whole God. He's concerned about everything. And I don't think that there's any other nonprofit organization in Haiti that's ever built a marketplace.
I don't think so. But let me tell you about the marketplace that's really too, Sherry and Pastor Jensen. The marketplace gives the Haitians hope. Yes. There's a Creole proverb, Sherry.
Yeah, it says, espoir fait vivre. Hope makes us live, or hope gives us life.
And Jesus is our life. And we're going to have a Christian radio station going through there, the gospel. The gospel's going to be going through because there'll be a lot of voodoo people coming in there buying. And also, you know, the whole bottom line is Romans 2 and 4. Because of the marketplace, people will see the goodness of the Lord, and it would lead them to repentance, and they will come to know the Lord. Romans 2 and 4. That's what it's all about.
Thanks, Bobby and Sherry. And now here's my dad to share how you can be a part of this exciting new project.
Well, I am so excited about what God is doing, and I believe that this program today has built and boosted your faith. I hope, I pray. We're praying for you here at Kingdom Connection. We're believing for God to bless you in unusual and amazing ways. And in our few moments of closing together, I want to challenge you. You know, this is a huge project that we're endeavoring to take on in Haiti. And it's an ongoing project. As a matter of fact, it's already started. We've already sent the first $100,000, and we're believing every month that we're going to have a $100,000 check that we can write and send. And we need that check right now, as a matter of fact. And I'm going to ask 1,000 people who are watching me today to pray about what God would have you do. And maybe you could be one of the 1,000. I'm believing for 1,000 people, and really 999, because I'm not going to ask you to do something I'm not willing to do. And my wife, Cherise, we believe, and I've had the privilege of taking my kids and my wife to Haiti. We believe in what we're doing there. I wish that I could get every one of you, you know, in a group on buses and planes and trains or whatever we had to do and take you there. If I could get you there, it would move you to your core, and you would participate in the miracle of what's happening. See, what is so beautiful is it's not just an ongoing problem, but we're coming up with a solution with this amazing marketplace ministry that we're believing to bless the Haitian people, the orphans, the hungry, the poor, the needy. It's going to bring dignity and hope to the people. Will you be one of the 1,000? I need 1,000 partners and friends to sow a one-time gift of $1,000 to say, I can be a part of that. You know, we can do this. We can't do everything, but we can do something. And we can, you know, I wish we could change the whole nation overnight, but we can't do all of that. But you know what? We can do something. We've already done something, and it's really made a difference. But this is the greatest. This is the greatest dream that we've had thus far. We've never done anything of this magnitude. And we're believing that God is going to speak to people just like you. Father, I ask you, your sheep know your voice. I ask you to speak to people all over this world and all over this nation. Thank you for 1,000 people that'll stand with me. And together, we're going to impact the nation of Haiti for the glory of God. Thank you so much. Pray for us. We'll pray for you. We'll see you next time on Kingdom Connection.
This program has been brought to you by the friends and partners of Jensen Franklin Media Ministries. For more information on this broadcast or for additional resources, go online at jensenfranklin.org.